Welcome back. Today we are going to discuss an AP chemistry question. The link to this question has been given in the description of the video. All the resources links are included in the video description as well. The question is, the Lewis electron dot structures for sulfur trioxide and for the sulfide ion are given above. Which statement best describes the geometry of these two substances? A. The sulfide ion has a triangular pyramid shape and the sulfur trioxide is a planar triangle. B. Both substances are flat triangular planar shapes. C. Both substances are triangular pyramids. D. Sulfur trioxide is a triangular pyramid and sulfide ion is a planar triangle. I will suggest you to pause the video here and try to figure out the problem by yourself. Hope by now you already have figured it out. Let us just now do it together. So, here we have these shapes, much bigger and cleaner version. So this is the same as this. This is sulfur trioxide and this is the same as this. This is sulfide ion. This is the Lewis electron dot structures of them. And we are going to find the geometry of these two substances. If you look carefully in the answer choices, you will see that there are two options for the molecular geometry. One is a triangular pyramid shape, other is a planar triangle. And all the other answer choices are just a combination of these two. Now, in order to determine the geometry along with the Lewis dot structure, we need to take the help of a model that is called the valence shell electron pair repulsion theory, or Vesper theory in short. And this is used to predict the shapes of the molecules based on the repulsion of the bonding and non-bonding valence electrons in the molecule. So this is determined by the number of bonding and non-bonding electrons in the molecule. In order to determine the shape, the Lewis diagram must be drawn first. And when determining the shape of a molecule with multiple bonds, treat the multiple bonds as if they were single bonds. Let me just show you here. So this is using Vesper to predict the shapes of the molecules. So if this is a covalent molecule where A is the central atom, X is the surrounding atoms with M numbers, and E is the number of lone pairs, E is the lone pair and N is the number of lone pairs, then we need to find the electron groups on the central atom. You can just see in the footnotes, these are given here. So electron groups include bonds, lone pairs and odd electrons. A multiple bond, which can be a double or triple bond, counts as one electron group. So if we have a molecule with two electron groups on the central atom, so this is the situation where A is bonded to two X molecules, there is no lone pair, it will have a linear geometry. If there are three central atoms, three electron groups on the central atoms, we can have two scenarios. In one, we have no lone pair, AX3. The A is bonded to 3X atoms, there is no lone pair, it will have a trigonal planar shape. Another situation arises when we have one lone pair. This is molecule is in the notation AX to E. So the A is bonded to 2X atoms and there is one E is the lone pair or non-bonding electrons. It will have a bent shape. Now when we have four electron groups on the central atom, there can be three scenarios in which one AX4, that there are no non-bonding electrons like this, all four are the ligands or the surrounding atoms, it will have a tetrahedral shape. Now if it is having in the notation of AX3E, that means there are three surrounding atoms and one lone pair, three surrounding atoms and one lone pair, it will have a trigonal pyramidal shape. There can be another situation where you have two surrounding atoms and two lone pairs, AX2E2, so two surrounding atoms and two lone pairs, so then it will have a bent shape. Now the question arises, why despite having the same electron group on the central atom we are having different scenarios? So as you know that these electrons here, they are repelling each other. Now if you just draw this one, so this is A is the central atom. This is surrounded by 2X atoms. So these electrons are bonding electrons. And it has also two non-bonding or lone pair of electrons. Now, we can write, if I have to order the repulsion, then I will have to say that the lone pair repulsion is greater than the lone pair bond pair repulsion, and that is greater than the bond pair repulsion. So we mean to say that this repulsion is the maximum, and then this repulsion, and then this repulsion. Why? This is very obvious because these bonding electrons are shared by two nucleus, so they have to be a little localized, And here it is this lone pair. This is this lone pair or this lone pair. They're controlled by only one nucleus. So they have more space to spread out. So the volume of the electron cloud is more. Because of the higher volume of the electron cloud, this lone pair repulsion is the maximum. And then this is the minimum. And what happens is, when you have this maximum repulsion, they go in the bent structure where the repulsion is minimized and it is a more stable structure. So because of this different order of repulsion between the bonding and non-bonding electrons, they assume different molecular geometry, and the aim is to have the molecular geometry which is more stable and that has the minimum repulsion. Now let us concentrate on our structures, the structures that has been given here. So if we see here, the sulfur trioxide, we have one central atom and there are three surrounding atoms. So we can write it, this is SO3. So the generic notation will be, if A is the central atom and O is the surrounding atoms, AX3 with no non-bonding or lone pair electrons. Non-bonding electrons we are considering only for the central atom here. So AX3, so this is AX3, so this is a trigonal planar shape. So we can write that this is a trigonal planar shape. Trigonal planar shape. What about here? So we have one sulfur atom, central atom. We have 1, 2, 3 surrounding atoms. And how many lone pairs of electrons we have here? 1, right? So we can write that this is SO3 and then there is one lone pair. So the generic notation will be A for the central atom, 3 surrounding oxygen atoms, and there is one lone pair of electrons. So this is the notation of AX3E. AX3 with one lone pair of electrons. So we have this trigonal pyramidal shape. So we can say that sulfide ion is trigonal pyramidal shape. So we have our answer. So the molecular geometry of sulfur trioxide is trigonal planar, while the sulfide ion is trigonal pyramidal. So the answer choice A said that sulfide ion has a triangular pyramid shape, yes, and the sulfur trioxide is a planar triangle, yes. So we will go for answer choice A. All the other choices are dealing with the other combinations. Now here, this is a interactive model simulation software. This is free and online. Let it just load. I will show you. So here you can just give your molecules and see what shape it is having. So we'll click on the model. Let me just get rid of everything. So let us first mimic the situation of sulfur trioxide. Let me just show you here. Sulfur trioxide, 2 single bond, 1 double bond, no lone pair. So 2 single bond, 1 double bond, and no lone pair. So what is the shape? It is the trigonal planar shape. So all of this will be one electron group. 1, 2, 3 electron groups with no lone pair will having a shape of trigonal planar. Now let us just see the sulfide ion. This is again having 2 single bonds, 1 double bond, and 1 lone pair of electron. If I just see here, we will see. So this is the same thing, just we'll have to add 1 lone pair of electron. There you go. So you can just rotate it to see. So this is having a trigonal pyramidal shape. So thank you all for watching my video. Please like my video and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Sarco Research and Education. Here I post educational videos on test prep math questions from ACT, SAT and PSAT math questions, and also AP biology and chemistry question. See you all in my next video then. Mahalo. Happy learning.